Have you encountered the side-by-side error 59 on your Windows system? No worries, in this video we will look at some fixes. For a more in-depth look at the topic, be sure to check out the article in the description. Let's run the Windows Store Apps Troubleshooter. Open Settings. In System, look for Troubleshoot. Go to Other Troubleshooters. Look for the Windows Store App Troubleshooter. Click on Run. Follow any of the on-screen prompts. Then, restart your system and try again. See if this resolves the problem. Next, we can run an SFC and a DISM scan. To do this, we'll open the command prompt as an administrator. Type in SFC space slash scan now and hit enter. This might take a few minutes. After that, type in DISM.exe space slash online space slash clean up one word hyphen image space slash restore health and hit enter. Depending on the amount of corruption, this could take as much as 15 minutes. After that, restart your system and try again. The error might be caused by Visual C++ dependencies that the application needs in order to run, so we need to find out what is missing and then download them. First, open a command prompt as an administrator. Then, type in sxstrace. Space, trace, space, hyphen, log, file, colon, sxs, trace, dot, etl, and hit enter. After it's finished, type in sxstrace space parse space hyphen log file colon sxs trace dot etl space hyphen out file colon xss trace dot txt and hit enter. Then type in sxs trace dot txt and hit enter. Look up to find out what VC runtime dependencies are missing. Then go to Microsoft's website to download the missing packages. We have a link to the website in the article. Install them and then restart your system. Check and see if that worked. After that, we can uninstall and then reinstall the app in question. It could be that the app was not properly installed or files in it became corrupted. Sometimes you just have to uninstall it and start over. To do this, go to Settings, go to Apps, go to Apps and Features. Find the app in question. And select Uninstall. Then download and install the latest version of the app and try again. Finally, if the problem persists, you might just have to reset your version of Windows. To do this, go to Settings, go to System, go to Recovery, then click on Reset this PC. Follow the on-screen prompts. For more helpful articles to help you maximize your Windows experience, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content aimed at making you the master of your digital house. Thanks for watching and have a great day.